Hi students, this is Ramalakshmi, Physics faculty. Today our topic is alternating current through a pure capacitor. What is the nature of a capacitor? A capacitor stores electrical energy on their conductive plates in the form of electrical charge. Now when a capacitor is connected in a DC circuit, how it behaves? A capacitor is connected to a DC source. So this capacitor is charged up to the value of the potential provided by the battery. So that means the potential difference in between the plates of the capacitor is equals to the potential difference provided by the external source. Up to that point this capacitor gets charging, and after then once it is fully charged, it doesn't allow any electrons to pass through the conducting plates of the capacitor. That means capacitor is saturated and it behaves like a temporary storage device. So even though when we remove the external source, the charge of the capacitor remains constant. When a capacitor is connected to an alternating source, this alternating source provides an alternating EMF V0 sin omega t. So this alternating EMF produces alternating current in the circuit. Because of this alternating current, the charge on the plates of the capacitor and electric field in between the plates of the capacitor changes with respect to the time, because the direction of the current changes periodically. Due to that, this capacitor takes place charging and discharging alternatively. So at any one instant of time, the potential difference across the plates of the capacitor is equal to the EMF produced by the alternating source. So we know the capacitance of the capacitor, C is equal to Q by V. So from this, V is equals to Q by V, Q by C. So at any instant of time, this potential across the plates of the capacitor is equals to the potential provided by the alternating source. Now apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law. So at the instantaneous EMF of the source, V is equals to V naught sine omega t. Let it be equation 1. So by applying Kirchhoff's voltage law, so at the source V naught sine omega t minus at the capacitor Q by C is equals to 0. And from this V naught sine omega t is equals to Q by C. And the charge on the plates of the capacitor Q is equals to V naught C sine omega t. But what about this charge? This charge changes with respect to the time. So then I is equals to dq by dt. Then d by dt of C V naught sine omega t. And from this C V naught d by dt of sine omega t is equals to omega into cos omega t. So we get I is equals to C V naught omega cos omega t. But we want the function in the form of the sine. So convert V naught by 1 by omega C I is equals to V naught by 1 by omega C into sine of omega t plus pi by 2. In second quadrant, sine 90 plus theta is equals to cos theta. Now we get the current in the form of the sinusoidal function. And here I is equals to V naught by, here 1 by omega C is equals to capacitive reactance. Capacitive reactance. Capacitive reactance is denoted with the letter XC. So XC is equals to 1 by omega C. The unit of capacitive reactance is also equals to ohm. Now, V naught by XC into sine omega t plus pi by 2. That implies I is equals to. So, maximum voltage by reactance. Reactance is nothing but resistance offered by the capacitor. So in this place, I is equals to I naught sine of omega t plus pi by 2. So equation number 2. So here V naught by xc is equals to peak current or maximum current. So maximum current I naught is equals to V naught by, in place of xc, 1 by omega c. So V naught by xc, where xc is the capacitive reactance. From these two equations, it is very clear to us, current leads the voltage at an angle of pi by 2. Graphical representation of alternating current. When time is equals to 0, EMF value is minimum 0 and I is equals to maximum I naught. So at time equals to 0, current value is maximum and the next EMF value is minimum 0. So now at 90 degrees, EMF is maximum, but what about the alternating current? It becomes to minimum. It is 0. Again, at this 180 degrees, EMF becomes to 0, minimum, and I becomes to maximum. So that means current leads EMF by an angle of 90 degrees. The phase difference in between EMF and current is 90 degrees. So the phasor diagram, the current through the capacitive, pure capacitor, and the voltage across the capacitor in between these two, that angle is 90 degrees. Power supplied to a capacitor. The instantaneous power supplied to a capacitor, P is equals to VI. We know instantaneous EMF V is equals to V naught sine omega t into I is equals to I naught sine of omega t plus pi by 2. So this term is look like sine of A plus P form. Expand this term. So V naught I naught sine omega t into sine omega t cos pi by 2 plus cos omega t into sine pi by 2. Here cos 90 value is 0. So this term completely becomes to 0. And here sine 90 value is 1. So the remaining term is cos omega t. So from this V naught I naught sine omega t into, here the remaining term is cos omega t. For the simplification purpose, multiply and divide with 2. So now this is look like 2 sin A cos B form. Then V naught I naught by 2 into sin 2 omega t. So instantaneous power supplied to the pure capacitive circuit, P is equals to V naught I naught by 2 into sin of 2 omega t. Average power in the circuit, P average is equals to V RMS into I RMS into cos phi. What about the pi in the circuit? The phase difference is pi by 2. So cos pi by 2 is equals to 0. So average power in the circuit is equals to 0. That means a pure capacitive circuit is connected to the alternating source. The power consumed in that circuit is equals to 0. What is the capacitive reactance? The resistance offered by a capacitor to the flow of alternating current is called capacitive reactance. So capacitive reactance analogues the resistance. Capacitive reactance are denoted with the letter xc. Xc is equals to 1 by omega c. So what is the unit of the capacitive reactance? Ohm. So from this, xc is equals to in place of omega 2 pi f into c. So here capacitive reactance depends upon frequency and capacitance of the capacitor. When frequency of the source increases, then what about the capacitive reactance decreases? So capacitive reactance and frequency both are inversely proportional to each other. In case of the DC circuit, so for DC current, we know frequency is equals to zero. So frequency equals to zero, then capacitive reactance is maximum. So capacitive reactance is maximum, it blocks the DC current. But in case of the alternating current, it depends upon the frequency of the source. So alternatively, in case of AC connection, it alternatively changes the direction. That means it takes charging and discharging alternatively.